Hey there, today on the workshop we're going to be reviewing Tetra's 9 watt UV clarifier. The reason you'd have a UV clarifier on a set of ponds like mine is to remove the algae. You can see that this has got kind of a pea soup color to it, even though I've got a ton of plants in there. I've got bog plants and lily pads galore and even papyrus in the center there and cattails eating up all the nutrients in the water. It's still high, kind of a high bio load, and you're going to get this greenish tinted water from algae. What a UV clarifier does is it kills off that algae by pumping water through a tube full of UV light. Ultraviolet light will kill the algae. It'll clump up and be filtered out by the pond pumps. Now what I've done is down here you can see I've got it hooked up to a 600 gallon per hour pump on a 1-inch line. This can take up to about 900 gallons per hour. I've actually got the UV clarifier hidden beneath a plant here. You can see it. It's got the in and the out. That's plugged into a power source. You don't want to run it unless the power is running water through it because of the fact that you'll burn out the light bulb inside. If you want to know if the UV light is working, you just look at that little indicator there. That'll tell you if that's lit up a purplish color, you know the UV is working. Then I've got that hose hidden underneath a bunch of other plants that runs around and it comes out into the waterfall right there. It just comes out underneath the waterfall so you can hardly tell the output is there. In fact, you can't see it from anywhere in the pond. So this is day one. I've hooked it up. It's running at the full 600 gallons per hour. I've got about a 1200 gallon pond here. It goes a couple feet down and you can see the upper level there in the back. The waterfall is running at 1200 gallons per hour. That's on a completely different pump system so that when I have to change the bulb in the UV clarifier, which has to be changed once a year if you run it 24/7 or every 6 months if you're in a climate like mine where it will freeze in the winter. You don't have to run your clarifier in the winter when the water freezes because the algae won't form. So this is day one. It's installed. It's running. I'm going to come back and see how it goes. Now they said it could take up to 2 to 3 weeks on a pond this size. The 9 watt clarifier is good for up to an 1800 gallon pond and you can run up to 900 gallons per hour of water through it. I'm running about 600 right now. So we'll come back couple days, see if the water's starting to clear up. We're back now. We're only about 24 hours in and there hasn't been any huge noticeable difference in the coloration of the ponds. The only difference that I've noticed in the past 24 hours is that the bright green algae has tinted to a brownish green algae, which I would assume means it's all starting to die off, obviously. You could tell from the other pics the other day that it was a little brighter green. Now it's getting darker as we go. So running at that 600 gallons per hour, we're exchanging the full volume of the pond every few hours through that UV sterilizer. And it's going to take a while for all the water to keep circulating. Once the algae dies, then it will start to clump up together and the filtration system will start to pull it out and then I can clean the filter. So we'll keep coming back. This is just day one. I'll come back in a couple days, see how it's going. 1 week into the process and you can see that Tetra's 9 watt UV clarifier has really done a lot of work. I mean, this is absolutely beautiful. There's no green hue to the water. It's nice and brown and clear. You can see fish way down, a couple feet down. The water is always going to stay brown in my ponds because I have a lot of leaves that tint it brown that I like, and I also use barley to tint it brown. But you can see that water is really, really clear. There's none of that pea soup look to it. It actually looks like pond water. The frogs are happy. You can see Mr. Frog down there. You can actually see the fish now when they swim around. Even the darker colored fish and the minnows. So everything looks great. What you'll notice when you start using your UV clarifier is that you will get clumps of algae like that are dead and floating around. Eventually those will all coagulate into an area where you can either net them out, or when they sink they will be removed by the pond pump and the pond filter. So that's it right there. It is an absolute hit. It works perfectly. There's no issues at all. We'll look at it from a few angles. Before you couldn't even see those logs in there. Now you can actually see them. You can see structure in the bottom of the pond. No pea soup look. And even the upper pond, which doesn't have the UV clarifier in it, but receives water from the waterfall up here, has cleared itself out as well. So it's done a great job on this 1,200 gallon pond. It says it works up to 1,800 gallons, and I have no doubt that it would. I highly recommend it. I can show you a little bit how it assembles down here underneath the plants. You've got your line coming in, which it'll take up to an inch and a quarter line, and then you have your line coming out. Like I said, I have it running at about 600 gallons per hour. There is a viewing window at night. You can look in that window and see if your bulb is still running, and you got a 15-foot power cord to plug that in, and it works perfectly. Thanks for watching this quick review of Tetra's 9-watt UV clarifier for ponds. It's a definite must-have for those of us that live where pond water starts to turn green in summer. And if you want it to look more natural, so that it's, you can actually see the fish and the frogs and the plants, go ahead, pick it up. You won't be sorry.